Once we get that atmosphere that's loving in your groups and with your counselor and all that kind of a thing, we're going to look at the behavior chain, which is this. The behavior chain. That begins with the stimulus. That means the cue or the situation. That can be music, it can be a certain part of town, it can be a friend, it can be a bar, it can be your drug dealer, it can be snow, it can be a bad weather, it can be good weather, it can be Tuesday, it can be Monday, it can be a lot of things, but it's a cue. Something happens that is a cue or a stimulus. And that leads to automatic, unconscious thinking. So, in childhood, many of us learned, I'm worthless, I'm stupid, I'm no good, I'm ugly, there's no hope for me, I can't make it, I don't fit in, a lot of things, but it's unconscious, automatic. So, we want to take a lot of time trying to pull on what you are automatically thinking. Because a lot of that thinking will trigger craving. Because that thinking is going to create feelings. Now, addicts have been hiding from their feelings for a very long time. We've been treating our feelings with dope. So really, it's hard for us to understand how we feel because we're feeling mainly numb. And we've been feeling numb for quite a long time. And the alcohol and drugs make us even more numb, which is kind of what we want because we don't want to feel. Well, you can't really take away one feeling without taking them all away. So you can't, like, take away your fear with drugs or alcohol or whatever, and not take away the love and the joy and the peace too. You take away one feeling, all of the feelings are taken away at the same time. So, something occurs, very quick, automatic thinking, much of it inaccurate. Much of it from childhood, inaccuracy. You may think inaccurately, I'm in such pain that I need something for my pain. Anybody that's in this kind of pain, again inaccurate, anybody that's in this kind of pain would need something for their pain. It's not wrong of me to think that I'm in pain and I need something for my pain. 63% of alcoholics relapse in a bar. Now, the question is, what are they doing in there? Because they're probably in there to check out the new pool table or to see what their friends are doing or see the bartender who's their good friend or to look at all the pretty little bottles up there. I'm just going in the bar to see my friends. I'm just going in the bar to check out the new carpet. And yet, you get in the bar, and all the smells are there, and the laughter is too loud in there because alcoholics cannot hear when they're drinking very well. And so they're talking too loud, and they're laughing too loud. And if you're not drinking, that's very obnoxious because they're too loud. And the reason they're too loud is they can't hear each other because alcohol has suppressed their hearing. Only 4% of addicts can quit on their own. The other 96% of them need help. And we have a real hard time asking for help. Because as little kids, when we ask for help, maybe people were not helpful. Maybe those people were harmful. One thing in treatment we're going to learn is to ask each other for help. to offer each other help. If you want to do something good for yourself today, you help someone else and you will feel better.